We was just sitting and rocking in the studio. And she began to tell me that, boy, you got roots in St. John's. How was that? And she began to tell me that your grandmother used to walk the railroad tracks from White Castle to St. John on Sunday morning.
All right.
And that was my mother's mother. And I said, well, Miss Vick, I said, that was a long walk. She said, but you're not understanding what I'm talking about. That St. John, Dorseyville is like a pillow for White Castle and Bayou Good. She said that they might have walked from Bayou and White Castle on the railroad tracks, but their shoes and their feet never worn out. That's why I feel compelled to talk about what Dorseyville means to me.
Yes, Lord.
Because it got great implications to me.
Yes.
By her sharing those things with me, and I wish I had a tape recorder that I could play. Because she shared so much.
Yes, Lord.
With me.
It's real.
That I just couldn't hold it or retain it all. But the things that I did retain was what I just shared with you.
Yes.
And she began to tell me, she said, you know how big those rocks are on the railroad track?
Yes, yes.
She said, but yet they walked it from our pumpkin ranch to St. John's.
All right.
To come in fellowship at a church that bought two areas to one. So I stand here to tell you that Dorseyville to me
come on.
Was the start of my family.
It's all right, yes.
Gave my family direction and understanding of what Christ really means in their life. But I also stand here to tell you that it was the start of the educational side of our lives also. Because that little old building across the streets is where many of us came and learned about ABC, 1, 2, 3. And I began to set our feet for more, longer and longer. And she began to tell me, she said, I can remember when we used to walk down to the river. Go and have the baptism and come back from the river.
Amen, that's right.
Come back and have worship and your grandmother leave church and walk back to Pumpkin Ridge. Here today we got to understand that Dorseyville has a lot of richness within it. Then it instructed and conformed all of our lives to where some of us are today.
Amen.
It made me be a better man than I am today.
Yes, Lord.
Because there was a man by the name of Basil Dorsey.
Yes, yes.
That the Lord put his hands on him and told him, I need you to go down here because my people are scattered. That's what I began to take from what Ms. Vick was sharing with me. And the hands of the Lord began to get upon Rev Darcy to bring White Castle and Bayou to a central location. And as they came to a central point, they formed St. John the Baptist Church. The Bible said when Ezekiel began to manifest the word of God to him, they began to come together. When Reverend Basil began to manifest the word of God to White Castle and Bayou, They began to come together and form Dorseyville. To where Dorseyville began to be a spotlight across the nation. Why is it a spotlight? Because out of this little community, we have lawyers that have left here.
Yes.
We have doctors that have left here.
Yes, Lord.
We have people in nature with major degrees that has left here.
Yes, Lord.
That's what Dorseyville means,
yes,
to me.
Lord. Yes, amen.
That I can sit back and look at the younger generation that is coming up.
Yes, Lord.
And only if they can found their minds around the things that Dorseyville mean to them. I can remember up in the purge.